Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Chellen. Today we have a question sent in by Ron from Dallas. If you have a question for the podcast, please leave your question as either a voicemail or just drop me an email, bill@MrExcel.com. Ron has built a form in Excel that he wants someone to fill out, and then they're going to print this form. And he said, hey, I figured out how to merge cells to make this particular piece of the form longer. But the frustrating part is that there's no way to make it stop at a certain number of characters. So for example, if someone fills out the form, and there's some important data that spills over the edge of the field, Ron would like a way to stop them from entering data that is beyond the edge of the field. Right now, if we printed this form, no one would be able to see anything that goes past the margin. He compared it to a typewriter. He says, you know, in the old days, basically a typewriter would stop typing when it got to the right edge of the paper. I mean, there was a limit, and there was a way to stop Excel from typing. Well, I had a couple of ideas for Ron, and neither of them are exactly perfect. But the first thing we want to do is we want to see basically how many characters we think can fit in that field. Now, unless you're using Courier or a fixed width font, it's going to be an approximation. So if I use the equal length function, LEN, it'll tell me that there's about 22 characters there. So what I can do is come back and use data and then choose validation. Now, in data validation, lots of times we use data validation to set up a drop-down list, but we can also say that we want a specific text length. So for example, we'll take data between a minimum of 1 and a maximum of 22 characters, and we can set up an error alert that says data too long, this field will only accept 22 characters. Click OK. Now this isn't perfect, because unfortunately what would be really nice is, like on a typewriter, if we had, you know, some sort of a ding when we hit the 22. In this case, if they enter something that's too long, it's going to tell them that it only accepts 22 characters. They can either retry or cancel. So retry, then they will have to go through and try and shorten it until it gets to the point that it is acceptable. However, this is going to be frustrating, because no one's going to know exactly where it is. It's going to take a few iterations for them to accept the information, and by that point, they'll be screaming, ready to kill the person who designed the spreadsheet. So data validation using the custom text length is one way to prevent people from creating data that is too long. And tomorrow's podcast, we'll take a look at another solution to this problem. So thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.